15 years on, still going strong. I'm Harrison101, and welcome to Gran Turismo 6. Hey everybody, Harrison101 back at it once again for a brand new video for you, and it's a very special one as we play Gran Turismo 6 on the PlayStation 3. This is a full-on Let's Play. I know I mentioned this when I finished Grid a couple of weeks ago. And, yeah, this is it. I know you guys have been waiting for this one for a little while, so thanks for your patience. It took me a little while to get used to the Elgato as well, but it seems to be working out quite nicely. So, first up, just got to enter our name. Hopefully not on the start of the Great Saiyan Man from Dragon Ball Z or anything. Allow me to tell you my name! But yes. I'm excited, man. I mean, I must admit, it's a bit tedious doing this bit again, because for those guys that follow me on Twitter, you may have already realised this is my third attempt at trying to record this damn thing. I made the mistake right off the bat of trying to record at 1080p quality, and my laptop couldn't handle it. This is at 720p, so hopefully it'll work out a little bit nicer. But yes, welcome! Oh, hey Harrison, this is Brands Hatch, one of Britain's best-loved racetracks. The perfect introduction to sports driving is taking part in a track day. This will give you the opportunity to experience a real racetrack. And I'm just going to put my controller charger in while I'm doing this, because it's Right, there we go. Controller charger is in, that's a bit embarrassing. First episode and I'm being unprofessional. We'll be putting you behind the wheel of the Renault Sport Clio RS 2011. Try to get a feel for how the car handles and moves. The driving line is displayed on the track. Use it as a guide to help you as you make your way around the course. When the line turns red, you need to apply the brakes. If you don't, you'll overshoot and end up off track. Controls are displayed in the lower left of the screen. Use these as a quick reference guide until you are comfortable. Try a lap and see how you get on. Stay calm and try to learn the layout of the track as you go. Good luck. So yeah, this is basically a tutorial. Just a tutorial of, this is more for people who are complete novices to racing games in general. It is basically driving 101. Firstly, focus on the basics of getting to grips with steering, accelerating and braking effectively. Try to follow the driving line as closely as possible. Like so. When the driving line turns red, this indicates the braking point. If you don't slow down enough, you won't make the bend. Stuff. Oh, I love Brands Hatch though, man. It's such a fun track. Very fast as well. Quick movements of the wheel will cause instability, so try to get into the habit of turning the wheel smoothly and steadily. Up the hill now. This is Surtees, I believe, so now coming down the hill now. Press the select button to change the view. Pick the view that suits you best. Okay, rule of thumb for the series, I'm gonna try and drive like this in the actual, you know, steering wheel kind of cam here, unless it's got a blacked out interior. General rule of thumb, okay? Cars need to be handled delicately when traveling at high speeds. Brake firmly and decisively, and only while traveling in a straight line. As you get used to the track, gradually increase speed through the bends. Try to find the optimal speed at which you can follow the driving line cleanly. Yeah. I must admit, they've never done a tutorial before in these Gran Turismo games, so it is a nice touch for those that are completely new to the series. Given this was the 15th anniversary release, it probably got a lot of hype, even though... Actually, now I think about it, it probably didn't, because of the fact that the PS4 was already out when this game came out, which kind of killed its hype, really. It's a shame. You should only accelerate out of a bend when you finish turning. Be sure to apply power slowly and steadily. Last corner. Then hang out wide a little bit, then come back inside. Excellent. So yeah, that's the basic tutorial. Just the one lap of Brands Hatch. And there you go. What a run! Nicely driven. And yeah, you can try that as many times as you like as well. If you're new to the series, if you didn't feel comfortable, you can redo that section as many times as you like. So, congratulations on finishing your first track day. As a reward, you've been given some credits to get you started. Let's use these credits to buy your first car. To buy a car, first select the dealership's icon. Why not start out by purchasing the Honda Fit RS 2010? Yeah, unfortunately, like in many Gran Turismo games, there's only a certain limited amount of cars you can buy right off the bat. And while the game is more generous with credits than it is in normal games, in this case 30,000, you can only buy one car straight away and you're locked out for buying anything else. And it's this. It's the Honda Fit RS. Because, unfortunately, no matter which way you cut it, a Honda Fit is still a Honda Fit. Let's get it in blue. So yeah, you have to buy this car before you can progress in the game. It's one of those suck it up moments more than anything else, I would say. But yeah, there it is, the Honda Fit RS. Lovely. Anytime you buy a car in this game as well, the paint colour you chose it in, you can now paint any car you own in that colour. So bear that in mind as well. Congratulations on acquiring your first car! Each car has a performance point rating, which gives you an idea of its overall capabilities. The Honda Fit RS10 has 350 performance points, for example. Certain races will require specific performance points in order to enter, so check the entry requirements carefully. The dealerships offer a huge and diverse range of cars. To browse and select a car, select dealerships from the high home screen to see a list of all manufacturers. By selecting recommended cars, you can see cars suited to certain difficulty levels in career mode, or from specific racing categories such as Super GT, Touring Cars, and NASCAR. So yeah, once you buy that, you can buy any other car in the game. It's not like Gran Turismo 5 where there were lockouts on dealerships or anything like that. Okay. I skipped the Red Bull X challenge notification there because it isn't really relevant for another 10, or maybe 20, 30 episodes because you don't unlock the Red Bull X challenge until you've got an International B license. Just bear that in mind. Now it's time to get you started in your first race. Go to the Novice class in career mode and select the Sunday Cup. I'll do that in just a minute, but as you can see, there's a lot of cool things in here. This is the new menu. You can now access everything from here, which is great. It's much better looking than GT5. Also, there's a shortcut button as well. You see the start button in the top right corner? That can be used as a shortcut. But yeah, a lot of cool stuff in here. Check out the Vision GT section next episode as well. There's some really cool concepts that are on the way for that as well. As well as seasonal events as well. We'll be doing some of those later on as well. You can't unlock them until you get a National A license, I think. So, just got to bear that in mind. But anyway, Novice. The Sunday Cup. A race event aimed at novice drivers who have just bought their first car. Test your skills in this entry-level challenge. So yeah, as you can see, but when you enter a race in this game, before you enter, it will tell you the entry requirements, what the performance points rating is, which you can't exceed. In this case, it's 430, which is odd considering you're locked into this car and it's only got 350, but the limit is 430. I find that a little bit weird. Anywho, you're also allowed sports hard tyres or less. That applies to a lot of events in this game. Unless it's racing cars, it's probably going to be sports hard as a tyre limit. Some cases it's sports soft. Just bear that in mind. It tells you the prize money as well if you win down to third. You do win money for every position in this game in Gran Turismo. Just bear that in mind as well. And it will also give you an idea of your general opponent you'll be facing in the race. It's not as detailed as Gran Turismo 5's, but it still gives you a decent idea of who you're going to face. Just to say it's not quite as in-depth as last time. Anywho, time for the Sunday Cup at the high-speed ring. Unfortunately, there's no real way of making a race of a Honda Fit sound particularly exciting, but I did my best. Right. High Speed Ring is one of those staple Gran Turismo tracks. It's an original track created by Sony themselves. Has been in nearly all the Gran Turismo games, except for 3, I think. It's been in all the other ones, which I find a bit puzzling that one of the staple games wasn't in Gran Turismo 3, which I'd argue is the best in the franchise. But hey, what do I know? I don't know why this Honda Fit in front of me, the older one here, seems to be bobbing and swaying on the straight. It's like it's going for a slide about 100 miles an hour. It's a bit weird. High Speed Ring, it kind of does what it says on the tin, really. It's a track with very smooth bends, very short, and very quick. Not very many slow corners at all, so you just kind of really maximize your speed and try and take smooth angles for everything and you'll be fine. As you can see here, 85 miles an hour through here, no problem at all. Through the bridge. They definitely revamped this track though for Gran Turismo 4, I think, when they brought it back, and it looks nicer than what it used to in the older games. Even from a graphical standpoint, because obviously there's going to be a big difference there. But it just looks nicer, cleaner, you know. Through the tunnel and back out the other end. We've got a Nissan Micra in front of us. My mum used to have a Micra, the older one with the 3 like oblong style brake lights at the sides. My parents' car history is a very funny one. Like, for instance, my dad had this awful Volkswagen Jetta when I was growing up. I was like 7 years old, and that car scared the shit out of me. Like, pardon me. Like, for example, it was so loud on motorways, it would scare me to death when my dad put the foot down, because it was so loud. The engine was awful in that car. And we finally convinced dad to get rid of it, and he got a Volkswagen Golf. Instead, there was a Generation 4 Golf, the really ugly and slow one, and it was a 2.3 litre V5, was the V5 version. Basically, it was a little bit better than the GTI, but not quite as good as the R32, which is, you know, the top spec Golf they normally sell. So, you know, that was fun for a while. It was much quieter. No, it was quite potent too. It had 170 brake horsepower. It wasn't slow by any stretch. But then Dad finally got his dream car about 4 years ago when he got a BMW M3, the E46 model. That was his dream car. But funnily enough, he only had it for a year. Then he swapped it for a BMW 645 CI. I remember my dad as well. That Golf he had some really awful rims on it as well. And I hope he doesn't find out I said this if he watches this video back, because he's going to kill me. Because I always hated those rims he had on that car. But he's got a 645 now. It's a car he blatantly can't afford to run, but he keeps it anyway. If you want to find it, it's on my Instagram page, at Harrison101. If you scroll down quite a far away, you can find it. But yay, first win in the books. We're off and rolling. Right, first win in the bag. Don't need to see the replay. You can see those after every race you complete. As you can see as well, if you log into the PlayStation Network every day in a row in consecutive days, you get given a login bonus. The first time up, it's a 10% boost to all of the credits you earn. If you do it up to 5 days in a row, you can get up to 200% as a bonus, so up to double credits. You've got to log in 5 days in a row for you to get that bonus. Also, the way of tracking progress in this game is now through stars. As you can see here, you get 1 star for completing an event, you get 2 stars if you complete an event and finish in the top 3, and you get 3 stars the maximum if you actually win. Congratulations on finishing your first race! You also managed to win on your first time out too! We are looking forward to seeing how you develop as a driver. In career mode events, you'll earn stars and credits based on your performance. Now get out there and try to clear all the novice class events. Right then, let's move on to your next race. Please select exit from the following menu. So there we go, first one in the books. Yeah, the game definitely holds your hand for a little while, but once you get into National B, you know, things start to go through a lot quicker. Can you see the startup menu up there in the top right? The start menu allows you to change the car you're driving, adjust various options, and carry out other useful actions. From the options menu, you can change which buttons perform various actions, such as accelerating and braking. You can even reassign your horn and windscreen wipers. Yeah, this is what I was mentioning earlier. You press the start button up here, and you get this great little option here where you can save time and basically change your car around, upgrade your car quite easily and whatnot. See, there's an option for those guys that want to save a little bit of time. Right, final race here in the Sunday Cup, it's Autumn Ring Mini. It's not the full Autumn Ring, it's the shorter version. Again, another Gran Turismo staple. Another original track, but it's just a smaller version. Autumn Ring Mini is much better designed for smaller cars and for karts. You'll see what I mean about that later on in the game. But if you're a kart fan, you'll be getting used to seeing Autumn Ring a lot. They had an Autumn Ring version, I'm pretty sure, for karts in Gran Turismo 5 as well. As a special event. Even though karts in this game are no longer special, so they're now in with the regular events. So how's this Let's Play gonna work? Well, it might involve a lot of editing, let's put it that way, because some of the challenges in this game are legitimately quite hard, like the Red Bull challenges, for example. License tests down the line can be a bit tricky now and again, so I have to wait and see how it goes, but there might be some edited footage in there somewhere. But for the most part, it will be live commentary, for sure. And hopefully, I can keep the login bonuses rolling as well, so I have enough credits to be able to use a better range of cars. Because that's the aim. I want to kind of show off, you know, the great range of cars that this game has. So I'm going to try and feature as many cars as I can in the course of the series. I know, like, you get given a really decent car right off the bat, and that's the Mercedes-Benz AMG Vision, which I'll show you in the second episode, as a gift. So you can use that in a lot of events very early on, and it's a little bit broken. Because normally it'll cost you 1 million credits to buy it, but the first one you get given is a gift for free, so, you know, it's a little bit broken like that. In fact, I will go out as far as to say the whole game in general is actually easier than its predecessors. It's easier to get golds, and I think it's easier to achieve more in this game, rather than, say, GTs 3, 4, and 5, where some of the challenges were legitimately really difficult. Just bear that in mind. If I can do it, you can do it too if you're watching. But that's the plan for the series. If I had to guess, I would say it's going to be about 70 to 80 episodes, because this actually isn't as big as the other Gran Turismo games that have come out previously, but it's still going to be a bit of an effort. Like, some of the sections like International B and National A are actually pretty darn big, and there's a lot of events to get through. But they have a much better range of events as well, which is also makes it more fun. And, you know, this Honda Fit is actually surprisingly fun little car, I'll say that much. And the last corner. And there we go, Autumn Ring Mini taken care of. Simples. And I love the victory music as well, wait for it. With the beat to drop and bam, yeah, that's awesome. I love that. I really do. Alrighty then. So that's about another 5,000 credits there. Now, I could end the video off here at the 25 minute mark, but I'm going to try and take care of the next set of events as well before we end this video. So it's going to be the first episode. You're all probably going to watch it anyway, so we're going to have some fun with this thing. So we have 6 stars. As a result, we have now unlocked the Amateur Cup. Collecting stars will unlock more events like this one, and collecting them all will earn you special rewards. Try and earn as many as you can. Yeah, the game isn't lying to you. If you complete a section and you get all its stars, you get the opportunity to take part in some extra events. Not so much events, just to get some extra cards, which are, some of them can be very good towards the end of the game. Right, the Amateur Cup. A race event aimed at beginners, which should prove slightly harder than the Sunday Cup. Don't worry too much about winning, just get out there and enjoy the challenge. So the first one up is 2 laps of the Brands Hatch Indy Circuit. The PP limit's been upped to 450, but don't worry about that too much because again, the opponents you're facing are probably have got even worse cars than you. It's a weird thing about this game, is that the PP limits are very, very generous. And the cars you face don't match up to the limit, you know what I mean? And it kind of has to be like that, unfortunately, because the game forces you to buy a car with 350 as a PP. But then they have a 430 limit on an event. See, that's a little bit weird. Anywho, Brands Hatch, the Indy Circuit. So, basically it cuts off certies and makes you go straight on and back on yourself, basically. So it's the shorter version of Brands Hatch, just the 2 laps. Yep, it's the same track you may have seen in the tutorial in case you weren't paying enough attention. it's just, this time it's the shortened version rather than the full track. As you come down the paddock hill bend. Look how early he was braking, yeesh. Yeah, the Gran Turismo AI is still kinda slow, not gonna lie. However, to compensate, they make you start from the back every time now, and it's now your mission to basically go through the entire field and eventually win at the front. It's basically like Gran Turismo admitting, okay, our AI kind of sucks, but, we're going to make it harder for you instead. It's like those GT4 mission races they used to have back in the day. Where you would stay in place for like 30 seconds and then, you'd have to chase down one car in a single lap. It's kind of similar to that here. But it's the entire game. Well, for the most part anyway. There's a few grid start events in there, but for the most part you're chasing down a disadvantaged leader. That's the start emphasis of the game right there as I go very wide there. Whoa. That was a mistake. I'm talking too much. Ooh. They are giving me a bit of a nudge. Shred to the outside there, that's pretty nicely done. Overtakes of the week! With Ryan Littlemore, when he actually makes a video now and again. Oh dear. Anyway, in the meantime, let's finish this up here. Just gonna hug that left apex there. But yeah, if you guys are enjoying this, please leave a like. I'd really appreciate the support. It's a brand new series. And I want to see if you guys are going to watch it or not. I'm really looking forward to seeing it. So, this could be a really fun Let's Play if it all works out. Here's hoping it does. So there we go. Brands Hatch taken care of. Very quick. Only 2 minutes 6 for the whole race. That was simple enough. And obviously, as you go on through the game, the prize money you get for events goes up as well. So we're up to 5,300 or so. And another 3 stars. If you've already lost count, we're up to 9 now already. 10 will unlock the Coffee Break Challenge. 15, so if I get all 3 in these events, will unlock the final test for the section, the graduation from the class, and that's the National B license. Right, next race up is the Grand Valley East Circuit. Grand Valley East is the eastern half of the entire track, the Grand Valley Speedway. Again, for those guys that don't know, Grand Valley Speedway is another one of those Gran Turismo tracks that has been around for, you know, multiple games. It's a bit more technical than some of the other Gran Turismo tracks that are out there. And this is just one half of it. This is the eastern section. It cuts out some of the deeper, more technical parts on the west side of the track. So just bear that in mind. Pretty fast track too. It's got some low speed technical sections in the middle, but there's a lot of high speed stuff as well. A little bit of everything in this Grand Valley Speedway track. Alright, so around the outside of this car here. Yeah, it's not as fun coming up on this track when the car is like not that fast up a hill. Like normally the track would go off to the left there, as you can see. Instead, it's going to be here. Ooh, ow! That was a big hit. Oh dear, that's a bit embarrassing. I shouldn't be hitting cars that are traveling this slowly. That doesn't look good, does it? Now that Paz Rubio in second here, this Mexican fella. That sounds like Ricky Rubio, the Minnesota Timberwolves point guard. Only he's Ricky and Spanish. But I'm really looking forward to some of the stuff deeper in the game as well. First guys, I noticed this is like kind of like my second playthrough of the game. I only got up to like the IB license when the first time I played the game, to be honest. So there's still plenty still to do, which makes it more fun. So by the time we get to the International B section, I'll be firing blind. So, you know, I only really started early so I could get an idea of what the game was like, the handling model, the physics, and, you know, knowing some information. So that I can, you know, inform you guys as well as entertain and educate. That's the whole point of this series. I want to try and be informative when it comes to some of the cars and as well as some of the tracks and things like that. But I also want to be entertaining and trying and make it enjoyable as well. That's the idea. You know me. I love doing feature commentaries, you know. I must admit, one of the guys I've started to watch recently that's been a big inspiration is Leo Parente of the channel Drive. You may have seen on YouTube, who is just excellent as a feature commentator. He did a video the other day talking about, you know, NASCAR and the NASCAR and how it's flawed from a marketing standpoint. So you may already be a NASCAR fan, you may just be held back by the advertising of it all, you know, all these guys just turning left and whatever. And he did a fantastic job of breaking it down and saying, well, you know what, look, no, maybe it's a little bit more complicated than that. And, you know, it kind of showed me that as a subject commentator, I've got a long way to go still. But, if we get the win here, that's nice. It's one of those things where I know a lot of people have been very complimentary towards me in the Fantastic Four series I've been doing. You know, we've got three of those out of the way. Lewis Hamilton's coming up later in the week, so look forward to that. But yeah. Thank you for all the kind words and the support on those videos. They've done very well. They've done much better than I thought they were going to. Especially the Riker. I think the Vettel one I'm really proud of. I think it's one of the best commentaries I've ever done. And I think I was about as fair and as down the middle as you could possibly be, considering I'm a Vettel fan myself. And you guys seem to really appreciate it, even if you didn't agree with me. And that's what it's all about at the end of the day. It's all about differing opinions in a community. I'm not trying to convince anybody to like the guy. And that's never been... Trust me, you guys are smart enough to think for yourselves as we go to Willow Springs here for the final race. You guys are smart enough to think for yourselves. And you've probably already got your opinion on Vettel and his success and how he got there and all that stuff. As long as you enjoy the video and appreciate and respect where I'm coming from, that's awesome. That's all I'll ever ask out of my viewers. So thanks for all the kind words on that one. I do really appreciate it. people saying that I should work for Sky, and it's like, you guys are so sweet. I mean, it means a lot to me. Me personally, I'm proud that I've been able to improve so much, but I still think I've got a ways to go yet, personally. We'll see how we go. It might make me, I might do more driver breakdowns in the future. Who knows? If you guys really, really like it, I wouldn't mind doing that. But yeah, this is Willow Springs. This is a brand new world track featured in the Gran Turismo franchise this year. You may not have seen this before. If you've ever watched the Clarkson DVD, The Good, The Bad and The Ugly, it was filmed here at Willow Springs. As well as, I think it was Series 19 of Top Gear and the USA road trip between the new Viper, the Aston Martin V8 Vantage, and the Lexus LFA. That was filmed at the airport, the Top Gun style sequence when they were shooting at them in planes. That was filmed here as well. So now it's in the game. There's a lot of layouts for Willow Springs as well, so look forward to that as well later on the line. It's one of those tracks that have a lot of layouts to it. This is the more high-speed one. I think it's called Big Willow. And it's a lot more based on top speed and you know, cornering speed at the higher end, because it's very straightforward. As you can see, I'm taking this at 110 miles an hour while taking a nice draft back here as well. There we go. This car isn't the fastest in a straight line in this event, but it makes up for it being ridiculously fast around the corners. That windscreen isn't very good, is it? Ah well. Final lap, let's get Petrov. Maybe I can do what Fernando Alonso did and actually pass him. There we go. Take that, Fernando. See, I can pass a Petrov. Why couldn't you? I'm joking. Sorry, Alonso fans, it was just a joke. Just a joke. Trust me, I love you guys, really. And when I came to the Alonso video for that Fantastic Four series, I had to sit back and really appreciate what the man has done in his career. As Kiel Champ quite rightly pointed out in my Vettel video, Alonso really has stood the test of time and has been a winner in three major technical eras of Formula 1 in the last decade or so, and that's a major achievement. And you know what? I can understand why people have him as the number one, I really do. I completely understand. And, you know, like I said, there's a very, very strong argument there. Depends how you want to look at it, really, you know. Do you look at it from the weaker car aspect and all that stuff? But, you know, you know the arguments. You've probably heard him a dozen times on YouTube or on Twitter or anything like that. If you're up on your social media, you probably know the score on that one already. But yeah, we'll talk more about that in future videos, I'm sure. This isn't Formula 1, this is Gran Turismo, damn it. And this game does have Formula 1 cars in it as well, just not the official ones. Like GT5, you may have seen, had the Ferrari F2007 and the F10, which were a handful, but pretty fun to drive. Only the Formula Gran Turismo in this year's game. But, hope it doesn't make it any less awesome. Alright! So that's the three amateur cup races done. See, kids, I'm productive. And we've now probably got enough credits where you could probably get another car if you really wanted to. We're now at 39,000 credits. And don't worry, I will be buying a second car, probably to end the next episode. But yeah, that's the amateur cup taken care of. We're now up to 15 stars in the novice section, which is exactly what we need to get everything. See? GT were clever like that. As you can see, coffee break challenges are now available. The coffee break challenges are mini games of a difference. Enjoy the chance to take a break from the serious business of racing. National B license tests are now available. Pass these tests to graduate from novice class. If you obtain a bronze award or better in every license test, you'll earn your National B license. Good luck. So we will do the coffee break challenge, the Novice Championship, and the National B license all in episode 2, because I'm so productive like that. Anywho, I really hope you enjoyed the new series. Just I dropped my controller on the floor, that's not a good look. But I hope you guys have enjoyed the first episode of this brand new series. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like. I would really appreciate all the support. And thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time. I've been Harrison101, and sayonara.